2024. My name is Winter.
And I'm Addie. It is a day 6.
The vision for nursery school is to prepare students for today and tomorrow by creating more hands-on learning experiences.
By respecting others' differences, we can create a better school and community for all people.
Today for lunch, you will have the choices of chicken tenders, ham and cheese melt, salad chicken with a roll, or PB&J sandwich.
Here's another special edition of Speaking with Stump. I wonder what dad jokes he can band together today.
Good morning, North Street. Welcome to Speaking with Stone. I'm Mr. Stone, and I'm here to get us over the hump. And I'm here to ask those tough questions. Today, I have Mrs. Rowler with us. And we're at the Mall of America, home of the Minnesota Vikings.
And the Twins, right?
Yeah, and the Twins. I do like the Twins. You know, I like Kirby Puckett growing up.
Me too.
I like Kirby Puckett. So, yeah, yes. You know, I only added the Vikings because I'm a Bears fan. So, like, you know, Chicago, Minnesota, like, kind of like a little rivalry. And I was going to be like, why am I at Minnesota Vikings? But Kirby Puckett.
Kirby Puckett all the way. All right, number 34.
I will go with that. All right, you know what? Home of Kirby Puckett. Way better than the Minnesota Vikings.
That's right.
Okay. You got something to say, Mr. Bear?
My wife and I, we went to Minnesota in 2014. We loved it. We went during the winter, too.
Mall of America?
I felt, definitely. I felt like little gerbils too, because each building has like its little tunnelway system, so you don't even have to step foot outside when it's negative 14 degrees out. I liked it.
All right. Well, this is about Mrs. Rowler, not yours.
Wait. It was Minnesota, right? Yeah, yes. Minneapolis and St. Paul. Yeah, loved it.
Can you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Sure. My name is Mrs. Roller. I have been here for 1 year. I'm so excited to be finishing up my first year here at North Street, and the bands rock. I teach band. So if you're a third grader, what instrument do you want to play next year? And then fourth and fifth graders, you guys are doing such hard and amazing work in that room. I live in Canandaigua. I've got 4 children. They age in ages 10 to 18. We're very, very busy outside of school. And I love to teach band. And I love teaching kids how to make music.
Awesome. If you were not a band teacher, what would you like to do?
If I was not a band teacher, I would be a farmer.
A farmer. Ooh. I wish, because like I want to like grow my own vegetables and things like that, and I don't. Just so you guys know, we film this on Tuesdays, not Wednesdays. So that's why you're here.
Insider secrets.
Yes, we're giving away stuff. But like every time I try, like I don't put enough effort into it. Probably, I just fail at growing vegetables. Like.
My big goal is to produce and provide and put up as much food during the summer as I can, so I don't have to go to the grocery store as much.
Yes,
during the winter.
I'm definitely.
However, I'm still there, aren't I, Mr. Barry?
Yeah, I always see that. Wegmans second home.
Oh, Canandaigua Wegmans is like anxiety central for me. Like mm-hmm. as soon as I pull in, I'm just like, oh, look at all the cars.
So
like,
fun fact, last year I had over 50 tomato plants, and I canned 60 quarts of tomato sauce for my family. And I think we're down to 12 quarts. My family eats a lot of spaghetti.
Nice. I like it. We do too. In the wintertime, it's like a Sunday thing, right? Mm-hmm. Get the pot going. So Mrs. Roller, something you might not know about me is when I was in high school and in elementary school, I played the trumpet.
Nice.
And I loved band. I was in band, marching band, jazz band. I was...
Fifth grade.
You guys got dismissed.
Not really. You better stay here.
So, yeah, I love band. I was first year trumpet. Was a drum major in the marching band. And I really, really enjoyed it. I think it's good for people to be well-rounded and to try different things.
Yes.
And if you're a band person, I think you should try art. If you're an art person, I think you should try music, and everyone try sports. And
you know what's awesome? So many of our band kids are sports kids.
Yeah, yeah.
It's so great because you can do it all.
Yep, helps you socialize and just learn new things. I definitely recommend
it. So 100%.
That's something about Mr. Stone.
That's awesome.
All right, so the next thing. I know something about you that the kids might not know about. And the reason why I brought you back to Minnesota is because you went to elementary school in Minnesota.
I did. I grew up in Minnesota. And I was, I started my school in New York State, but my family moved to Minnesota when I was in second grade. And I went to school from second grade all the way until ninth grade in Minnesota. So I started my musical journey in Mr. Chesbo's band, playing the French horn.
Awesome. Very cool. So now, when I'm speaking with Stone, this is like the tough, tough questions. This is what we're really trying to figure stuff out. So Mr. Stone loves chicken wings.
Mm.
Okay. So, flats or drums? Which one do you like?
Drums.
Drums. All right.
I'm the music teacher.
Yes.
The drums.
All right. So, blue cheese or ranch?
Depends on my mood, but probably blue.
Oh, you just, like, Mr. Barry has been waiting and waiting all year for the moment where someone was going to sit down with me.
And say ranch?
No, blue cheese and drums. Everyone says flats and ranch.
Nuh-uh.
Yeah.
Blue all the way, man.
Yeah. Mr. Barry.
It looks like your taste buds work.
If I'm out of blue cheese, ranch will do.
Yeah. I know. I hear you. Okay. Little known fact. Did you know the longest English word is 189,819 letters long?
Why?
I have no clue, but could you imagine that spelling bee? Like,
good luck, guys.
Yeah. How long does it take to say the word?
What is the word?
I have no clue. I was like, I couldn't pronounce it.
Do you know the word?
Mr. Bear, you're going to have to look that up. Plug.
Yeah, the segment's going to be like 20 minutes
long. We're talking too much. What else?
It'll be whatever that word is. It'll take up 15 minutes. Say it.
All right, it's dad joke time. Mr. Stone loves telling dad jokes.
So not do I.
Yeah, dad jokes are the best.
Okay. By far.
So I would tell you a construction joke, but I'm still working on it.
I got my drums, man.
I don't know. It would be perfect. All right, what do you call a belt made of watches?
I don't know. What do you call a belt made of watches, Mr. Stone?
A waste of time. All right.
See, that's a good one.
Dad jokes are the best. The kids are telling me my dad jokes are getting better, so I love it. All right, so speaking of love it, so the way that we end Speaking with Stone is love it, like it, never again. So
okay.
Love it all the time, like it, sometimes, never again. So I know that. So you talk about you're a farmer, or you want to be a farmer.
I am a farmer.
And you have chickens.
I do have chickens.
So, pet edition, love it, like it, never again. Chickens, dogs, cats. You can love one, have them all the time, like it, never again.
That's hard.
That's why Mr. Stone asks the tough questions. Speaking with Stone, that's what it's all about.
Love it, cats. Like it, dogs. Never again, chickens.
Never again. Get rid of the chickens. They're out the door. All right. Well, Mrs. Roller, I hope that you had a great time with Speaking with Stone.
It was awesome. Thank you for inviting me.
Yes, thank you so much.
Have a great day. Have a good day, North Street.
Right. Make a great day, North Street. All right.
Two.
That is all the announcements for this morning. I'm Winter.
And I'm Addie.
We take care of ourselves.
We take care of each other.
We take care of our school.
Make it a great day, North Street. See you at lunch.